Hello friends, I am Deepak Jain from Skill on Tech. In this video, I will present you a brief overview of how cement is made. Importance of cement can be assessed by the statement that concrete is second most consumed material on this earth, and cement is the most important ingredient of concrete. Generally speaking, cement is a binder used in construction. When it sets, it hardens and adheres to other ingredients like sand, gravel, bricks, stones, and keeps them together. Cement is of two types, non-hydraulic cement and hydraulic cement. Non-hydraulic cement is slaked lime and it does not set inside water. It is formed by calcination of calcium carbonate. Then quicklime is produced. Then quicklime reacts with water to form slaked lime. This slaked lime, when applied on walls, absorbs carbon dioxide and forms crystals of calcium carbonate. In hydraulic cements, which is also called Portland cement, they are set by hydration of powdered clinker. In this presentation, from now on, cement will be this Portland cement only. Major raw material for cement are calcium carbonate rich minerals such as limestone, marl, chalk, etc. Sometimes mudstone or claystone are also used, which have low calcium carbonate content. Based on desired mineralogical composition of clinker, correctives such as silica sand, iron oxide and bauxite are also added. After identification of raw materials, they are taken out from mines using blasting. These blasted rocks may vary from dust to very large rocks which are more than 1 meter in size. Here in this video you can see a blasting in limestone mine. Blasted rocks are loaded in dumpers and hauled to limestone crusher to prepare raw material for cement plant. These dumpers have to run for several kilometers on a very uneven terrain in loaded conditions, and hence they are a huge source of cost of diesel and maintenance. As blasted rocks are very heterogeneous mixture of rock sizes from powder to more than 1 meter in size, and also vary a lot in composition, they are crushed to size less than 50 mm in large crushers. Then these crushed material, they are transported to cement plant for making stockpiles. These stockpiles which are made in a very scientific way. They are made such that maximum homogenization can take place. Homogenization is very important for smooth functioning of kiln and for uniform composition of clinker. Crushed mineral from mine crusher is stacked using these scientific patterns in huge stockpiles. It is called stacking. These stockpiles can be as huge as 40,000 metric tons. These stockpiles are scrapped using reclaimers in a particular pattern, so that maximum homogenization can take place. This homogenized mineral is transported from stockpiles to separate grinding bins such as low grade limestone, high grade limestone, iron oxide, etc. Carefully mixed feed from these hoppers is fed to vertical roller mills or VRMs for further grinding. In some old plants, ball mills are used for the same purpose. The product of the VRMs is expected to be 1% residue on 212 micron sieve and 15% residue on 90 micron sieve. More coarse particle size will result in poor calcination, while finer particle size will result in more dust circulation and coating problems. Here you can see an FLS ATOX VRM. Here the vertical rollers, they are pressed against the table by hydraulic pressure and crush the feed coming in between. Feed is coming through chute at the center of table and moves out due to action of centrifugal force. This centrifugal force causes particles to further move outside as they are crushed below the rollers to the nozzle ring. The fine particles are carried away above to dynamic classifier, which is situated above in the vertical roller mill. This classifier allows fine particles to leave vertical roller mill, while the coarse particle or rejects, they fall from the center cone to again center of the table. The coarse particle which are not able to be lifted by nozzles are collected and then are transported by mechanical conveyors to be recirculated again with the feed. Raw meal after grinding in VRM are stored in homogenizing silos. From this silo, it is fed into preheater tower. Preheater tower are a series of 5 to 6 cyclones, one above each other. These cyclones act as heat exchangers. As hot gas is coming from kiln system, they lose their heat. While this raw meal is heated from 60 degrees Celsius at the entry point to 850 degrees Celsius at the bottom cyclone. After bottom cyclone, this enters into pre-calciner system. Pre-calciner is a combustion chamber where up to 65% of total required heat is provided. Here, most of the heat is required because the calcination of limestone is a very endothermic process and requires a lot of energy. Clinker formation is actually an exothermic process, so not much of heat is required there. So as the hot meal leaves pre-calciner to enter the kiln, temperature reaches 1050 degrees Celsius. Rotary kiln is also a combustion chamber, but it is rotating. Also, it has a high momentum burner, which is able to produce flames with temperatures exceeding 2000 degrees Celsius. Rotation is important here as it helps in formation of clinker nodules along with mixing of minerals. Part where hot meal enters the kiln is called kiln inlet, while the burner end is called kiln outlet. Burner is about 1 meter inside the end of kiln. Inside kiln, where flame is at its maximum, the minerals melt at 1450 degrees Celsius and fuse together to form new mineral phases. Clinker is a mixture of these phases. Bigger the kiln, lower is the specific cost of clinker. So kilns are getting bigger and bigger these days. Till 2019, the world's largest kiln had 13,000 tons per day capacity. It is 93 meters long and 6.6 meters in diameter. This year, that is 2020, Shri Cement has commissioned world's largest cement kiln in the United Arab Emirates with 14,500 tons per day capacity. In this slide, we will understand what is clinker. So, as described earlier, clinker is a mixture of various minerals artificially produced in a cement kiln after calcination of limestone. The clinker mainly consists of four minerals called allite, bilite, tricalcium aluminate and ferrite. The phase diagram represents here the presence of various minerals at varying temperatures inside preheater, precalciner and kiln. The temperatures are presented here on the x-axis, while the various phases are presented here. Like in preheater tower, we can see it is mostly original composition with elevated temperature. When it reaches calciner, it becomes lime and bilite along with aluminate phases. However, in the burning zone, it tries to make maximum of allite, which is desirable till 75%, and liquid phase is also present. while when it is cooling, then halite, bilite, aluminate and ferrite phases are present. Clinker made in kiln is very hot and it needs to be cooled before it can be used. So coolers are installed just after kiln outlet, where a series of fans cool the clinker from compartments below cooler grade bars. Air also serves a purpose to recuperate up to 70% of heat from hot clinker. Here, air is coming from compartments below and it is taking away the heat from clinker bed. As clinker bed is moved forward using the crossbars, the bed is also cooled, loses the heat, and the heat is taken away by the air. The bigger boulders in this clinker bed are crushed by these crushers so that they can be transported and used later. Clinker cooled from cooler are transported and stored in huge silos. These silos can be as large as 1 lakh metric tons. Then appropriate feed mixture of cement is prepared along with other minerals, admixtures and materials in desired proportion before it can be grinded in cement mills. Cement mills can be combination or standalone of high pressure roller mills, VRMs and ball mills. A ball mill photo is shown here and a video is also shown here. In ball mills, grinding is done with the action of steel balls, which fall after rotation onto material and crush it. Ball mills can also be quite large, like several meters in diameter and up to 10 meters in length. All the cement which is prepared in these mills is not same. Cement can be categorized based on its strength, that is 33 grade, 43 grade and 53 grade, where each grade represents 28 day strength in megapascals. Cement can also be classified based on the composition, such as OPC or ordinary Portland cement, which has 95% clinker and 5% gypsum, PPC or pozzolana Portland cement, which is 65% clinker, 30% pozzolana and 5% gypsum, and PSC, which is Portland slag cement, which has 65% blast furnace granulated slag, 30% clinker and 5% gypsum. Finally, when cement is ground to desired size and made of desired quality, it is stored in cement silos of capacity up to 10,000 metric tons. From here, it is sent for packaging in automatic machines or for cement transport bulkers. Here in this video, you can see a 16 spout automatic packing machine. Here a worker is putting empty bags on the spouts and the filled bags are falling off from spout onto a belt conveyor. From this belt conveyor, they pass through dust hoods and then they are transported to their desired destinations, which can be a truck, a loader or some storage warehouse. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, hit like button below and share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe to our channel for getting updates on other upcoming videos. We have more videos coming on cement for more technical aspects. Also, please leave any comments or feedback to improve our videos. Thank you and have a nice day.